Hello, YouTube. Today in the Naughty Librarian, I am doing a little Smutty book haul. I can't believe Smutty September is almost over already. It went by so fast, but it's Smutty September, so I had to pick up some new Smutty delights. So let's go over what I picked up this month. I've got some good ones here. But before we do that, I'll tell you what wine I'm drinking, because you guys like to know. Today I have this Vermentino, and this one's from Tuscany rather than Sardinia, which is where they're usually from, but it's a really, it's like a medium-bodied white wine, very strong, like lime, honey, and there's kind of like an herbal quality to it. So I think if you're having like a vegetable dish, it could really stand up to it, because vegetables are really hard to pair with wine, but I think Vermentino knocks it out of the park, and it's just delicious in general, so. Okay, let's get into books. First things first, I got The Raquel of Wrath by Emily Howard. So this is the sequel to The Beast of Bezek. And I read that one, I enjoyed it. I'm interested to see where this one goes, because this one is Isabel, and she was a sister of the heroine in the last book, and she is tenacious, she is devious, and I want to see what happens next. So at the end of the last book, we find out Isabel marries the Marquess of Wrath. So basically, they get married, and he just, like, leaves her at this country estate, and he goes back to, like, London, I guess, because he's, like, the owner of, like, a gaming hall, and he's trying to, like, you know, be, like, a fake rake so he could, like, scam people out of money for a noble cause, but, like, he just left his wife in the country, and Isabel is just not, like, you know, a fainting damsel in distress. She's very tenacious, and you know what she's been doing in her free time? She's been writing a women's sex advice column. I don't know where she's getting the advice from, because, like, she's obviously not with her husband, so who knows what's happening. But anyway, she's had enough is enough, and she goes and she's gonna be like, hey, listen, we're not doing this anymore. Very cool. So I'm excited to see where this one goes. I like Isabel, I like her tenacity, and yeah, she's gonna put him in his place, and I'm here for it. I also got a copy of Bombshell by Sarah McLean. This is her latest release, and this was sent to me from my wish list from one of my lovely subscribers, Myra. Thank you so much for sending this to me. I am obsessed. We're following Cecily. She is the titular bombshell. She's very scandalous. She's like living her best life, doing whatever, going out to the gardens at parties with strange men. You know, she's doing what she wants. And then you have Caleb, her brother's friend, and like, there's attraction there, but they're like, no, we can't act on it. And like, Caleb's low key, like trying to keep her out of trouble, cause she's like a handful. And I don't know. I don't know if there's like other plots happening. I don't know if she's really just like being loosey goosey in the bushes, or she's doing something else entirely that has nothing to do with paramours. Who knows? But I'm gonna read it. I feel like there's probably going to be some sneaky espionage-esque escapades? Who knows? But yeah, I'm really excited for this one. Thank you so much, Myra, for sending it to me. I also got a copy of Accidentally Compromising the Duke by Stacey Reed. Stacey Reed is a new romance author that I only found this year, and I'm obsessed with her books. I'm trying now to get into the back catalog, and so this is the start of this Wedded by Scandal series, and it sounds so cool. So you have Adeline, right? She is kind of, I don't know, I'm assuming her parents have betrothed her to this like nasty earl, and she's like, no, 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 I got it. I am just going to have to be caught in a compromising position with someone else who's not this crappy guy. And so she's like, I got the guy. I know who I'm going to do it with, and he's cool. He'll marry me. It's fine. He's nice. And so she goes into his room at night to be caught in a compromising position, you know. Whoopsie daisy, wrong room, ends up in bed with this duke. And he's like, oh no. So now they've been compromised with each other, and he's going to have to marry her. And he was looking for a wife anyway, because he's got two daughters, and he's just like, hey, like, this could work. Although, you know, of course, like, it's gonna be like a fake marriage or marriage in name only, but really they're gonna fall in love for real and just like can't stop touching each other, especially in the genitals. And I'm obsessed with that kind of story. But yeah, Stacey Reed is like a new author I'm super obsessed with, so I'm excited to get back into her back catalog. I also got a copy of The Royals Next Door by Karina Howe. And okay, you know what? If you're looking for spice, I recommend Karina Howe books, or Hallie. I'm not 100% sure how she says her last name. I really should find out. But I've read like so many of her books. They're all extra spicy. So much smut. Delightfully smutty. I recommend for spice. And we're following Piper in this one. She is a young woman. She's kind of helping take care of her mom. She lives on this island. And wouldn't you know, one day, these British royals move in next door. And she's like, oh no, because it's just a media frenzy all the time. And of course, there's a strong, sexy bodyguard named Harrison who's grumpy. And I'm like, ooh, I love grumps. Okay. And of course, they're going to get like embroiled in scandal and stuff. And Harrison has to save the day. And you know what? Maybe Piper's going to save some days too. Who knows? But like, I am so down. Her books are so funny, so smutty, just delightful to read. So yes, I highly recommend checking her out if you haven't yet. From Book of the Month Club, I got Portrait of a Scotsman by Evie Dunmore. This is the latest book in the League of Extraordinary Women series, and it's book three, and I have, well, you know what? I really liked book one. Book two was like a little up and down, but this book, I feel it's going to turn itself around. I'm really excited about it. This one is Hattie and Lucien. Hattie, she's an artist. She wants to, you know, her plans are, you know, to be an artist because these are all extraordinary women and, you know, women's suffrage, all that kind of jazz. And she also just wants to marry a nice guy who's a gentleman. Enter Lucien. Not one of those guys. He's a kind of gruff Scotsman, ruthless business guy. He basically, you know, self-made man, brought himself up by his bootstraps, but also lacking power. Like, he has a lot of money, but no real power. And Hattie, she's got a title, so he's just like, all right, let's do this. And the thing is, with Hattie's, like, connections and stuff, he can finally get revenge. Like, he's on a revenge quest. And then, you know, they also have to, like, be married to each other. It's gonna be one of those, like, marriages of convenience, fake, like marriage in name only kind of thing, and then they fall in love for real, and I love it. I never get tired of it. It's like I know exactly how it's gonna end, and I'm happy with that. I just want to see people fall in love. Is that so much to ask? I don't think it is. It's Smutty September. I'm living my best life. And last but not least, also from Book of the Month, I got The Love Hypothesis by Allie Hazelwood, and I have been hearing so much about this book. It's super hyped right now. And I know my friend Mara from Books Like Whoa absolutely loves this book, so I needed to get it. Stat. So you have Olive and Adam. Olive, she is like a third year PhD student, lab scientist kind of lady, and she's like, okay, you know what, I don't really think romantic relationships are a thing. And it's like, so she's like, okay, I need to do something. And she just kisses this guy, and whoopsie daisy, it's Adam. He is a like a professor who's grumpy and kind of the reigning lab tyrant, and like, oh no, she just kissed him. But for some reason, like, he's into it, and he's like, okay, like, I'll pretend to be your fake boyfriend. And then like things go from there, and there's like science conferences, and it's like nerd love, and like they're fake dating, and then they're gonna fall in love for real. Is there a pattern here, guys? I think there is. But I hear nothing but amazing things about this book, and I'm so excited to read it. It just seems right up my alley. Obviously, I love a good fake dating story, and I love grumps. So it's grumpy fake dating. Yes, it's like all of my things I like. All right, so those are my smutty delights I picked up this September. I'm pretty excited about all of them. And, oh boy, all the smutty delights. I'm so happy. Also, hey, let's talk for a second. I was thinking about doing a new series on this channel, kind of like a live series where on like a weeknight, I haven't decided which one yet, I would do a live show and we could all drink wine together. Basically, I would announce which wines I'm gonna do like the week before. So if you guys wanna buy the wine, you can buy it and we can all have like a little wine tasting together, talk about books. I am really excited about it. I don't know if you guys are. Let me know if you'd be into like coming to a live show wine tasting thing. Let me know in the comments down below. Also, let me know what smutty delights you got for Smutty September. Put it down in the comments below. If you like this video, make sure you give it a like. And if you want to see more videos, make sure you subscribe. And I'll see you guys soon.